how a teacher should talk to students. Some people think they are a little strict. Being strict is not a problem. Being harsh is a problem. Many a times teachers are harsh, but they believe they are strict. Being strict is good, disciplining. Children will understand that. But when you are harsh, you hurt the core of the child. Sometimes it causes irreparable damage. I would always request teacher friends everywhere, be kind to the students. Be careful about what you speak in the class. Check every time whether you are hurting the core of a child. Sometimes you destroy the children by using harsh words. One such thing happened. It was in a beautiful school in Delhi. The English teacher was fabulous, excellent teacher. Children loved her. One day she was teaching them poetry. She taught a poem, explained it. Children were excited about it. She said, "Why, children, we should read somebody's poems only? Why can't you write poems? On your own experience, you can write a poem. It's good. So next Monday when you come, each of you should write one poem, small or long, whatever, on your experience. Bring it. I'll rate it and give grades for it and distribute it." Children were so happy. First of all, they loved the teacher, and this assignment was also beautiful. They went back home, pestered their parents, sat with them and wrote lovely poems. Monday morning, all the 40 children had brought poems. Children was happy and teacher was happy because all the students wrote the poems. She told them, "I'll take it home. Wednesday, when I come to the class, I'll evaluate all the poems and give grades." And Wednesday morning, children were ready to receive the comments about their poems. They were so happy. She took each poem and said, "This is a beautiful poem. The content is beautiful. Is A, graded A. This is beautiful. Content is good. Language is superb. I can't expect this language from a 6th standard student." She appreciated everybody and distributed the poems. Students were happy. They were all budding poets now. She started the class. One boy stood up in the class. His name was Vikram. Vikram said, "Ma'am, I'm sorry, ma'am. You forgot to give my paper, ma'am. I had also given a poem. You're not valued and given." Till then, the teacher was smiling and cheerful. When Vikram said, "You are not given my paper," I don't know what happened to this lady. Her face became red. She became angry and said, "Stop it. Keep quiet. Are you not ashamed of asking this question? First of all, you should be ashamed of asking this question. I am ashamed of you. I had told all of you to write a poem of your own. You copied from some other poet and brought it here. Shame on you. I didn't want to discuss that in the class. On top of it, you stand up and ask why your poem is not given. Is it your poem?" The boy said, "Ma'am, no, I have written. It's my poem, ma'am." "Shut up. I know what you are up to. Don't talk to me. I am ashamed of seeing your face. Cheat. Sit down." And the boy sat down and started crying. He felt miserable. He wanted to talk to her as she went out of the class. She was fuming. He had no courage to talk to her. He cried and cried. And slowly, his anger against the teacher started building up. He went and sat on the last bench. Every time she came into the class, he would sit in the last bench. He waited for that year to be over. Teacher also did not give much attention towards him, because she said, "He's a cheat." The year ended. Next year, another teacher came. But this boy started hating that English teacher so much. Finally completed his 10th standard and went to a college. By then, Vikram became a prolific writer, beautiful writer. His articles started getting published in international journals even when he was in college. And he got the international award. He became a celebrity in Delhi. He started traveling all over the world. By the time he finished his graduation, he was recognized as the greatest writer of India. He is traveling all over. Days went by, years rolled. One day he was in Delhi in a hotel for a conference. And a phone call came to him. Some gentleman was speaking on the other side. He said, "Are you Vikram?" He said, "Yes." "I'm sorry, Vikram, I'm disturbing you, but I have a request to make. Can you come to our house tomorrow, anytime convenient you, for 5 minutes? Vikram said, "Sorry, sir, my diary is full. I can't travel anywhere. I no time at all. The gentleman on the other side said, I know, Vikram, you are very busy. But my wife has been pressurizing me for last 3 years, saying that please call Vikram home. I want to meet him once. And my wife was your teacher. Oh, my teacher? Which subject she taught me? Which college? Which school? And the husband mentioned the school name. And she mentioned, my wife taught you English. Vikram was more excited. I remember all my English teachers. What's her name? He mentioned the name. And suddenly Vikram's face became hard. It is the same teacher who had criticized him and called him a cheat. Immediately his voice became hoarse and said, sorry sir, I can't come. I have no time. And the gentleman pestered again and said, I know Vikram, you don't like my wife. I know that you don't like her. Situation is different, Vikram. For last 3 years she is suffering from cancer. She is on the final stage. And doctors have left hopes of her. She is keen that she should meet you for 5 minutes. I don't know, every day she is asking me, can you bring Vikram for 5 minutes? For her sake, can you come for 5 minutes? Vikram looked at the diary and said, okay sir, tomorrow I'll come. Only for 5 minutes. I have to rush elsewhere. It's okay, please come, I'll wait for you. Next day Vikram went to the house, the small middle class family. Husband took Vikram inside, took to the room where the lady was sleeping. Vikram could not even recognize her. The body was totally emaciated. He pulled a chair and sat next to her. Husband went out so that the teacher and the student can talk to each other. This lady struggled hard to sit up, held Vikram's hand in her hands and said, Vikram, you recognize me? He said, yes ma'am. What happened to you ma'am? You've gone down so much. He said, no, don't worry. I'm just going out. Is one way of going out. I wanted to meet you. Child, can you do one thing? There's a cupboard in the room. Open the cupboard. Under the newspaper there, I got a cover there, brown cover. Please bring it. For a teacher, a student always remains a child. Vikram got up, went to the door, opened the cupboard and brought that envelope and gave it to her. He said, open it. When Vikram opened the cover, there was his poem that he had written when he was in 6th standard. Teacher had preserved it. She started crying, held his hand and started sobbing. Vikram, will you pardon me? So stupid of me that I shouted at you on that day. I insulted you, called you a cheat. I can't pardon myself, you know. I thought a 6th standard child cannot write a poem of this order. I couldn't believe it. I thought you copied from somewhere. But now I realize you are a gifted writer. You know, I valued the paper again. On that day when I valued the paper, you know what is the grade I had given? She showed the paper. With a red ink she had marked F. Fail. Crying, she showed, I valued the paper again recently, you know. With a green ink she had marked A++. She held his hand, slowly leaned on his shoulder and started crying like a child. He consoled her, ma'am, it's not your mistake. Mistake is mine also. I stood on ego. I should have come to the staff room and told, ma'am, no ma'am, I have written. If you want, I can write another poem and show you. I should have proved my innocence. I didn't do that. You were sitting on arrogance. I was sitting on ego. Both of us drifted apart, could not meet together. We lost 15 years in that process. Ma'am, forget it. It's over. You remain my favorite teacher even now. Then, after some time, Vikram left the house, came back to the hotel with a heavy heart. Next day morning at 5:30, there was a call. Same person, the teacher's husband called and said, thank you Vikram, very kind of you that you came to the house and consoled my wife. There is the greatest relief in her. And I should also tell you, just half an hour ago she died. This lady was living only to apologize to the student. Please remember, my dear teachers, when you talk to your students, be kind, be considerate, don't be in a hurry to shout at them. Possibly your understanding is wrong. One harsh word can destroy a child. One word of encouragement can take the child on cloud nine. Before you open your mouth and make comments about a child, think twice. That will be good for a teacher.